All right, let's talk TCP and UDP. We've already talked about the transport layer in general. Now let's get into a little bit of detail about the protocols, the two major protocols that operate at the transport layer. Again, we're talking about connections here between applications. So first up is UDP. UDP stands for the User Datagram Protocol. And like I mentioned in the other video, it's connectionless. It is unreliable, but not in a bad way. It just means that it's not going to guarantee that anything arrives when it's supposed to or where it's supposed to. And it doesn't have any flow control. So as soon as UDP has data to send, it sends it. And that's how it operates. And at the protocol level, we have a UDP header that has 64 bits. And the only information that's in there are the source and destination ports, a little bit of information about the length of the datagram, which is what the user datagram protocol calls its data, the length of the datagram, and then a checksum to check for errors to make sure that nothing got corrupted on the way. TCP, on the other hand, the transmission control protocol, is a connection-oriented protocol, which handles that connection with the three-way handshake, and it has sequence numbers, so it's the more reliable of the two protocols because it uses those sequence numbers to make sure that everything arrives and that the receiver has all of the pieces of the message that was sent. And so let's take a look at that three-way handshake. The three-way handshake is three messages that are sent back and forth between the client or the sender and the server or the receiver. And this three-way handshake is used to set up the connection. So remember, picking up a phone, the phone rings, the receiver says hello, I say hello back, and we're good to go. That is the three-way handshake. So the first message from the client to the server is a SYN, SYN, synchronize. And in response, the server responds with a SYN ACK, or synchronize and acknowledge. And that's the server's way of saying, okay, I hear you, I'm ready to talk. Or in other words, it's the server's way of saying hello when it picks up the phone. And finally, we have a completed connection, and the client sends an ACK to say, all right, we are ready to go. And once that ACK is sent, then the server knows that it has a completed connection. So as far as the TCP structure, remember the UDP header had 64 bytes. So it covered basically the first two lines of this, of a TCP header. Now the TCP header has significantly more information, including source port, destination port, just like UDP, a sequence number to keep track of all the messages that are being sent and make sure everything is received, an acknowledgement number, because the server acknowledges every single segment that is received. So when the server receives a sequence number, it's going to send back an acknowledgement to say, hey, I received the message that you sent. And then there's all this other information, a data offset and a bunch of flags, 1-bit flags to mean various things. You'll see right down the middle here, we've got ACK. So if you're sending that initial, or let's see, the SYN is right here. So if you're sending that initial message, you're going to turn this one SYN bit to be a 1 instead of a 0. And the server in response is going to respond with a ACK and a SYN both being a 1. Then we have window size, and then we have a checksum, an urgent pointer, and options offset. So rather than the 64 bits of a UDP header, we have about 160 bits in a TCP header. So significantly more overhead. Now, one thing you'll see here that we haven't talked about yet is a window size. This right here, this window size, is TCP's way of doing flow control. And the window is operating using something called a sliding window. So what that means is that the sender transmits a few messages at a time, a few segments or packets at a time. And then before sending any more, it's going to wait for acknowledgments on those packets. So here's an interactive demonstration, and we'll pull this up and try it out just for a second, just to show what this looks like. So we have a window size here of 5, and you see the gray box, that means there's 5 packets, or 5 segments to be transmitted. And when we click start, it's gonna transmit those. And the green messages coming back are acknowledgments from the receiver. And as we see this move forward, as each message is acknowledged, the window moves forward and the sender sends another message. And this is gonna keep moving one message at a time. Now, if we delete one, we can click on it and delete a message. Then you'll notice the sender doesn't receive or doesn't send, or the receiver doesn't send an acknowledgement. And when it receives later packets, it's instead going to resend acknowledgements for the last packet that it did successfully receive. And then when the receiver or the original sender times out, it's going to retransmit those packets that were already sent because it's realized that the receiver hasn't received them properly. And that's really what TCP does. And I'll put a link to this, and you should play around with it for a little bit and see what happens. And remember, you can click on the messages to kill them, and that represents packet loss on the network. And that can be very useful for understanding what we're talking about when we talk about retransmitting and when we talk about how this is handled. So the last thing we'll go over more or less is the TCP overhead. So we looked and saw that TCP has a 160-bit header instead of a 64-bit header like UDP. It handles source and destination port, but really the benefits that it provides are extremely useful if you need them. Now, we talked about a few protocols that don't need them and would prefer to not have the overhead that TCP provides, but it provides a lot of benefits. Sequence numbers and those acknowledgments make sure that every packet arrives intact. And when they're received, and that makes sure that when you send a video or a file or a movie or a long document across the network, that every bit of that document arrives and gets put back together in the same order. So that's pretty handy. And that's something you don't have in UDP. The handshake makes sure that the connection is available before sending it a bunch of data. And it makes sure, and really it's setting up that connection and setting up the parameters for the connection so that we can use things like sequence numbers inside of that connection to make sure everything arrives and to make sure that the connection, the device is available before we transmit. And finally, flow control, so machines don't get overwhelmed. So that window size is adjustable, and a smaller window size is going to reduce the amount of data that the server has to deal with at one time. And if a server is very busy, it might shrink those window sizes for its connections. And if a server is not so busy, then it can increase the window sizes and allow that data to come in a little bit faster. So just a little reminder, TCP is a connection-oriented protocol. It's the reliable protocol, and it has that congestion control. And UDP is unreliable, meaning it doesn't guarantee that every message is going to be there. And it's connectionless, so it doesn't have that connection, and also it doesn't have any form of congestion control. And here's a little TCP joke. Go ahead and pause the slide and read through that. It's pretty funny. And I also have a UDP joke, but I'm not sure you'd get it, and frankly, I don't really care. Okay, the last thing I want to talk about, so there's some newer protocols that are actually being created. QUIC is one of them. We talked in another video about HTTP2 being an offshoot or an extension of the SPDY protocol, which is Google's protocol that they created to be a better version of HTTP. Well, Qwik is another Google protocol that they are using to be a slightly faster version of TCP. So they haven't changed TCP and they haven't changed UDP. Really, what they're doing is building at that application layer on top of the transport layer protocol some features of TCP over a UDP connection. And one of the big benefits is that it doesn't have that handshake to start a connection. So you don't have that delay before you can start talking, and it enables communication to start faster than it would in TCP. And there are other transport layer protocols besides TCP and UDP, but those are far and away the most common protocols used at that layer. And that's our overview of TCP and UDP. So you have a little bit of an idea now of what those protocols do and what the differences are between those protocols.